All right, y'all, we're going over TUMs, Unit 23 in our book, pages 227 through 236. I'm going to go over the homework questions that you will have to submit in Skyward. The notes should have been done in class already. So let's get started on page 231. Keep in mind the formulas that you should have written from class. Volume formulas. The STAR reference sheet is going to give you these, but I have given you these. So you can write these down and make note of them somewhere. These will have to be stuck to memory because you cannot use extra notes on the STAR test. You can use these notes on my test though. So this is for a rectangular prism, triangular prism, and a rectangular pyramid, and a triangular pyramid. Remember, half of a triangle and a third of a pyramid is what we're looking for. We're talking about 3D here and 2D here. So number one, it says a rectangular shipping box is 12 inches wide, 18 inches long, and 24 inches tall. How many cubic feet does the box hold? So we need 12 inches, 18 inches, and 24 inches. Cubic feet has to do with volume, and it's rectangular. So this is a prism. I'm going to do length times width times height. So I'm going to take each number and multiply them. Number two, Julie uses a tent like the one shown to go camping with friends. The tent is 7 feet tall, 10 feet wide, and 12 feet long. You have to identify this shape. And choose the appropriate formula. Is this a rectangular prism? Is this a triangular prism? You're either going to do volume equals length times width times height, or volume equals length times width times height cut in half. For number three, it says the Science Museum has a terrarium in the shape of a triangular pyramid. This tells us what it is. The volume of a triangular pyramid, I need to go to my notes. Triangular pyramid is length times width times height divided by 6. I'm going to do length times width times height divided by 6. What is the volume of the terrarium? There are 3 numbers here, and I'm going to plug each one in. The order doesn't matter because you're multiplying. Then I will divide by 6. Number 4. Jackson purchases 2 candy bars. What is the difference in volume of the 2 candy bars Jackson purchases? So I need to determine the shape. Choose the appropriate formula. And then subtract. Find the volume here and here, and that's what we're subtracting to see what the difference is. Difference in the volume. Number 5, a rectangular prism. It tells you what it is. And according to the formulas that Ms. Starling gave you, I would advise that you use length times width times height. It has a base area of 56 square feet and a volume of 840 cubic feet. So they're giving you the base area. Which is 56. So that's the length times width. Length times width equals 56. Then they're telling you that the volume equals 840 cubic feet. Find the height. The length of the base is longer than the width. If the sum of the length and the width of the base is equal to the height of the pyramid, what is the length of the base in feet? Record your answer and fill in the bubbles on the grid. Be sure to use the correct place value. Okay, page 232. The Cotton family purchases a glass sculpture in the shape of a rectangular pyramid. They're giving you the shape. The base measures 7.5 inches by 5 inches. If the volume of the sculpture is 75 cubic inches, what is the height of the pyramid in inches? So if the volume of a rectangular pyramid, go back to my formula. Length times width times height divided by 3. I'm going to plug in the values that I know and leave what I don't know as a variable. I know that the volume is 75. I know that the base is 7.5. Whoops. Times 5 times height over 3. Talk to me about that when I'm done recording, please. I need to solve for h. So I'm going to multiply these, and then I'm going to get rid of this 3 somehow. Or whatever I do to it, I have to do it to both sides. And then I have to get rid of this 7.5 times 5 from both sides as well. Number 2, a crayon is shaped like a triangular prism. They give you the name of the shape. The formula for the triangular prism is length times width times height divided by 2, where my length and my width is my base area. If the crayon is 90 milliliters long, this is my height. How many cubic centimeters of wax is used to make a box of 8 crayons? So once I find the volume of one of them, I need to multiply it by 8 because I don't want one crayon, I want 8 of them. Number 3, Sam purchases 5 goldfish in an aquarium with a rectangular base. Sounds like this is the name of my shape. The aquarium measures 24 inches long, 8 inches wide, and 10 inches tall. They're giving you numbers here, length, width, and height. Sam fills the aquarium with water so that 1 inch of space remains at the top. 1 inch of space remains at the top. How many cubic inches of water are in Sam's aquarium? So I need to take 1 inch from the height. Then do volume equals length times width times height. So you have to determine which one of these is the height. Take 1 inch off and then multiply that by the length and the width as well. Number 4. At the skate park, a new concrete ramp is built in the shape of a right triangular prism. There's the name of my shape. As shown, how many cubic feet of concrete are used to build the ramp? Remember, volume of a triangular prism is length times width times height divided by 2. And then you'll be done once you do that. Oh, be careful. You don't need the slant height. No slant height needed. And if I were you, I would draw a right triangle, label it, and figure out which number is the slant height, because that's the one that you don't need. Number five, look at the figure. This is a right triangle and it comes to a point, so this is a triangular pyramid. Where volume equals length times width times height divided by 6, where the length and the width are the area, length and the width divided by 2 are the area of my base. What is the volume of the pyramid, if the volume of the pyramid, good Lord, is 12 cubic inches, what is the height of the pyramid in inches? So they're giving you the volume. So I gotta write my formula and plug in what I know. I know that the volume is 12. I know that the length and the width of my base is 3 and 4. I don't know the height, and I know that it's divided by 6. Again, this is another one where we're working backwards, so we have to get rid of the 6, and whatever we do to the right, we must do it to the left. And then we have to get rid of this 3 times 4. And whatever we do to the right, we must also do to the left. And we are solving for height here. Last page. Gobble one chocolate comes in a package shaped like a triangular prism as shown. Each triangular face of the prism has a base of 2 inches and a height of 2.5 inches. Triangular prism, where the volume equals length times width times height, cut in half. What is the volume of the package? You're just plugging everything in. We also need this 10. Number two, look at the figure. What is the capacity of the figure in cubic centimeters? This is a fancy way of asking for volume. The base here is a triangle, and it comes to a point. Figure out which formula you need and what type of shape this is. Figure out the type of shape first. Number three, the top of the Washington Monument is shaped like a rectangular pyramid. Volume equals length times width times height divided by 3. That's what my note said. The pyramid top has an approximate width and length of 34.5 feet and a height of 55 feet. What is the approximate volume of the pyramid top in cubic feet? Rectangular pyramid, yep, length times width times height divided by 3. Welcome to my video for those. Because they only gave you one number for the length and the width for the base of a pyramid, we're going to assume that it's a square, so it'll be 34.5 times 34.5. Then you get to do the rest. Don't forget to divide by 3. And don't forget the number that goes here. Last, the toy box has a volume of 9 cubic feet. If the height of the box is 18 inches, which could be the dimensions of the base of the toy box? 9 cubic feet, and this is inches. So I've got to convert this 18 inches to feet. 18 inches equals blank feet. Figure that out, and then find the volume, which is length times width times height.